This is a Creality Falcon 2 22 watt laser engraver, which is advertised to cut through 50 mm wooden board in just one pass and also can engrave color images on stainless steel. But its features and capabilities go far beyond this. I invite you to see me taking that challenge and more. The Creality Falcon 2 has a large working area of 400 x 450 mm for the laser, which is big enough to place A3 or tabloid sized materials inside the frame. I bought a bunch of materials and spent over 2 weeks thoroughly testing the machine's performance, safety features, engraving and cutting capabilities. First, some words about Creality's engagement with laser engravers, then you need to know about the safety features and how to protect yourself. Next, I have to get it up and running and make some projects to get used to it before we will finally see if the Creality Falcon 2 really cuts this massive wooden board in one go. Spoiler: I failed first, but then I got even better. And if, after watching the video, you like to get this machine, using the link in the description, you get a 10% discount on the Falcon 2. Creality is long known for its self-developed and manufactured FDM and resin 3D printers, which are very popular in the 3D printing maker community and began extending its portfolio in 2021 with its first laser engraving machines, the CV01 Pro and the first Falcon models. With the Falcon 2, Creality has decisively advanced the development of consumer-friendly devices that can be used by more than just tech nerds. It was released in February 2023 and is one of Creality's latest milestones in their ongoing evolution and improvement on their laser engravers. A high emphasis is on delivering machines with state-of-the-art features as well as safe and secure operation. The Falcon laser engraver was provided to me free of charge by Creality for review purposes. I also received the honeycomb grid, which is not part of the basic package. After the first tests, I decided to buy the cover with the smoke extraction. You will see in the course of the video why this is a good idea. Creality supported the creation with a review guide, otherwise my review policy applies, which prohibits any influence by the manufacturer, so I can provide the most neutral and unbiased review. In case I had problems or issues or needed to contact support, I will mention them throughout the video. This also includes the minor problems I encountered during the test, which I was able to solve myself without the help of support. The Falcon 2 is supplied with a pre-assembled frame and only a few simple steps are required to put it into operation following the quick guide. It took me no more than 6 minutes. Mount the four risers with the pads to each corner. The mounting holes allow you to put them closer together to fit your table's size. The height of the engraver can be raised using the provided additional risers to fit thicker objects under the laser head for engraving. Take the air assist pump, remove the rubber protection from the air nozzle and push the silicone tube over it. Next, plug it into the connector on the side. The dial above can be used to manually adjust the airflow when in operation, which can be useful to fine-tune to get better results. The 22-watt laser combines the power of 4 6-watt laser diodes using the latest FAC spot compression technology. Slide the laser head in place and fix it with the two thumb screws. Then plug in the connector to the small control board. I wasn't able to plug it in first. Looking into the connector, I recognized that some pins were slightly bent. After bending them carefully back, the plug went in with all problems. Now plug in the power supply. A 22-watt laser is quite powerful and can cause serious injury if handled carelessly. Therefore, before switching it on for the first time, a few words about safety and the built-in safety features.
The Falcon 2 has, besides the main switch on the side, a key switch and an emergency stop button. A laser engraver isn't a toy, so it's good that you can prevent your kids and other unauthorized persons from accidentally turning on the machine, using the key and taking it out. At least it adds a barrier that lets them think of why that is. When something dangerous happens during the use of the engraver, the emergency stop button immediately powers off the machine. It locks into place and must be unlocked before work can continue with the laser cutter. Furthermore, the laser is equipped with a bidirectional limit switch that stops it if it hits a boundary. For even more safety, a tilt detector will stop the engraver when the machine is lifted during operation. The orange protective cover in front of the laser serves as a first measure to protect you from the scattered laser beams. As a second measure, you should always wear Sweetwill safety goggles when working with the laser engraver. The goggles supplied do have a CE, ANSI Z87.1 and EN166 marking. Unfortunately, this does not say much about the quality of the protection, but they seem to do their job. If you want to buy another safety goggle, take care that it is suited for the 455 nanometer wavelength of the Falcon 2. They should have a high OD rating of 7 plus or higher too. Don't buy the cheapest. Good protection is never cheap. On the front of the laser head are three LED monitoring indicators labeled Air, Fire and Lens. They inform about the named operation condition with their color going from green to orange to red. Green means everything is okay, yellow indicates a state that needs your attention, and red a probably serious problem that you should take care of after turning off the machine if it has not already stopped the machine. If the machine stops on a red condition, is determined by the settings 153, 154 and 155. Check their value by sending $$ using the command line in Lightburn or LaserGRBL and enable them by setting them to 1 or disable them by setting them to 0. The airflow indicator helps to detect problems like the silicon tube being squeezed accidentally. Under normal operation, it gives you a rough estimate if you have set the airflow too high, medium or almost off. If a flame is produced when cutting flammable material, this is detected and the flame indicator changes to red. At the same time, to protect the laser head, it is moved to the front left corner and changes to orange. Once the fire has been extinguished, the indicator can be reset by pressing a button on the laser head. Cutting can then be continued by pressing the start button. Over the course of using the engraver, dust and residue from cutting can accumulate on the lens, decreasing its efficiency. So, at the latest, when the lens indicator turns red, it's time to clean or replace the lens. To do so, take the laser head out, unscrew the black nozzle, then wrap the soft cloth around the tip of the plastic tweezers and gently wipe it clean. Then reassemble everything in reverse order. In case the lens got damaged, replace it with a spare one from the supply kit. I have one last tip. Almost any material you engrave or cut can produce harmful smoke and gases, especially when using acrylic, which produces chloroformic acid with the humidity in the air. Good ventilation is always required. It's best to use a cover with a smoke extractor like this one and put the tube out of a window. A good breeze protection can't be wrong to use too. Let's start testing. To use the engraver, you have to install LaserGRBL, which is free, or Lightburn, which you can try out for 30 days. You find prepared settings file for Lightburn on the SD card. When I tried to import the prepared profile for the Falcon 2 into Lightburn, it didn't show in the file dialog. It turned out that its file extension was wrong. After manually entering *.lbdev in the file name box, when pressing enter, the profile could be selected and loaded. There are two ways to use the engraver. Standalone, by putting the SD card with the file to process into the SD card slot above the power switch. It then uses the file with the newest timestamp. Using the buttons on the front, first check the working area of the file by pressing the frame button and adjusting the position of it using the arrow keys until it moves completely over the material under the laser head. Then start the engraving or cutting by pressing start. I like the second approach better because it gives much more control. Connect the Falcon 2 to your laptop using the supplied USB cable. There is an adapter in the supplies in case you only have USB-C. The first things I did was doing material tests with various materials like the supplied pieces of basswood, stainless steel of 0.8 mm thickness and 4 mm thick basswood. I also tried clear acrylic, though I knew it couldn't work because 455 nanometer laser light passes through clear materials without doing anything. It just caused some little burn marks on the surface. After I had determined the parameters for cutting and engraving on 4mm basswood, it was time to start the first project. I bought some bamboo breakfast boards and wanted to engrave cute panda bears. So I looked up the parameters to engrave on bamboo and started Lightburn, loaded the image, scaled it to the size I wanted it and gave it a try. And here's the result. Looks nice. Then I searched the web for vector files and found this cute, nice robot, which I wanted to build and cut it out of my 4mm basswood. I was able to cut all the parts, but then I found out that the parts didn't match because obviously the file was made for 3mm thickness and not 4mm. So I did it a second time after upscaling the model. And this is the result. Doesn't it look cute? Then I decided it was time to do something more creative, for which I also could use some 3D printing, and came up to make a puzzle of the German map with all its countries and use 3D printed pins to make it easy to take out and put in the puzzle pieces. The next challenge I decided to take was if I could engrave colorful images in stainless steel. So I loaded the image of a butterfly into Inkscape, colored it to my liking, separate each color into its own layer. Then I exported the layer separately as SVG and loaded them into Lightburn, as well each one on a separate layer. Then I took the material test I made on stainless steel as a reference to find out the parameters for the colors I wanted to see on the final result. Unfortunately, as you can see here, the result is not yet satisfying. After the normal stuff, it's time to do tough things. Trying to cut the 50mm wooden board I showed in the beginning. Well, here's the result. It didn't work. I tried all settings and combinations for cutting I could think of, only to find that most times I just caused a badly burned cut or even set the wood on fire.
So, why didn't it work, and is the advertising wrong? No, the advertising isn't wrong. The first problem, I didn't have 15mm basswood for the test, only spruce. It's harder, and probably the board was pure spruce. The second problem, all the settings one can choose in the software are quite overwhelming. And though I was able to get some nice results using 4mm basswood and the first results doing color on stainless steel, I have to admit that laser engraving is not 3D printing. I still have a lot to learn about how to use the Falcon 2, what materials work with which settings, and so on. It may be even better to cut thicker material in several passes. I think that will give a better result than just one pass. That's not time to give up. I found an even thicker board with 17.5mm thickness in my workshop, so I started doing some test cuts, starting with 120mm 100% power, going down to 40mm per minute. And well, what should I say, the sweet spot seemed to be around 50 to 60mm per second and the material didn't catch fire. So it's time to give it a second go and see how it works out. And here's the final result. It really did cut through 17.5mm wood in one pass. I only engraved the logo multiple times because the first time it was barely visible. And another thing you can see here is that the cut went through, but not at all places. So maybe I should have gone with 50mm per second instead of 55mm. Who knows? And there was a crack in the board, so some of the letters just broke off. And I had to glue them together. But all in all, it looks nice. I really fell in love working with the Creality Falcon 2 laser engraver, though I'm normally into 3D printing, but I think this can be a very good accomplishment to make projects which combine 3D printing and laser engraving. On the pro side is that it has a large working area of 400mm times 450mm, then it's very fast. It's set to reach up to 25,000mm per minute, though I guess that's not what you use in your day-to-day work with a laser engraver. Normal speeds are around 6,000 to 12,000mm per minute, and that's already quite fast, isn't it? Then we have the really powerful 22-watt 455nm laser, which I found very impressive to watch working. Okay, sometimes I was scared to see that power. Next on the list is the adjustable air assist. It really helps to fine-tune the process of laser engraving and cutting. Then there are the monitoring features, which monitor the airflow, look for fire, and tell you if the lens needs to be cleaned. Really nice. The safety features are mentionable as well. The last thing on the pro side is that it can engrave colors on stainless steel, titanium, and aluminum. What's on the con side? First, you don't get a honeycomb with the base package. You have to order it separately. Second, the machine does not come with an enclosure, so you have to buy an additional protective cover with air ventilation. I can highly recommend that. Without, I wouldn't have been able to do that video. Because before I got that cover, my workshop sometimes was filled with smoke and I couldn't breathe. Next on the con list is that it has no Wi-Fi or Ethernet, which means you have to connect it to your laptop or PC or use the SD card, which limits you to only burn the latest file on the SD card. The last thing I wished it would have is a touch screen, which it hasn't. Thanks a bunch for watching, everyone. If you'd like to support my work, please subscribe and don't forget to explore the other videos in my collection. Happy laser engraving, and next time 3D printing again, here on 3D Printing Geek.